Have you ever wondered what the difference between cement and concrete is? It's a common misconception that these two terms are interchangeable. But in reality, they refer to two distinctly different things. Cement, my friends, is not concrete, and concrete is not cement. It's like comparing flour to a loaf of bread. Flour on its own is just a powder, but mixed with other ingredients and baked, it transforms into a loaf of bread. Similarly, cement is a powdery substance that, when combined with water and aggregates, turns into the sturdy, ubiquitous material we know as concrete. Cement is the glue that holds everything together. It's made from limestone and clay, and undergoes a meticulous process to become the binder we use in our concrete mix. The other components, water and aggregates, play equally important roles in the formation of concrete. So, cement is to concrete what flour is to a loaf of bread. Let's delve into how cement comes to be, shall we? Cement, a cornerstone of construction, has a rather fascinating origin story. It begins with a simple journey to a quarry, where two key ingredients, limestone and clay, are extracted from the earth's crust. These raw materials, the backbone of cement production, are then crushed into a fine, powdery substance known as raw meal. This raw meal is a blend of calcium, silicon, aluminum, and iron, elements that play a crucial role in the cement-making process. After the crushing stage, the raw meal is ground even further. This grinding process helps to create a consistent fine powder that is essential for the next phase. Now, things start to heat up, literally. The powdered raw meal is subjected to intense heat, reaching temperatures of about 2700 degrees Fahrenheit. This is where the magic happens. The heat triggers a series of chemical reactions, transforming the powdered meal into nodules known as clinker. This clinker is the semi-finished product, the heart of cement. Once the clinker is formed, it's cooled down, but it's not ready to become cement just yet. The cooled clinker is ground once more, but this time with a few additional ingredients. Gypsum and other additives are included in the mix to give cement its unique properties. Gypsum slows down the setting time of cement, allowing it more time to be worked with before it hardens. The other additives can vary, each one lending a different characteristic to the final product. Some may increase resistance to chemicals, others could improve the cement's workability, and some might even enhance the cement's color. So after a journey that begins in a quarry and involves crushing, grinding, heating, cooling, and more grinding, the cement is finally ready. It's then bagged and shipped off to construction sites worldwide, ready to play its part in creating structures that stand the test of time. And voila, you have cement. But cement isn't the only star of the show. When we talk about concrete, we're talking about a team effort. One of the key players in this team is aggregate, a component that often doesn't get the spotlight it deserves. Aggregate, which can be made up of materials like sand, gravel, or crushed stone, plays a significant role in the strength and durability of concrete. In fact, it makes up to 75% of the concrete's volume. Imagine that 3/4 of your concrete structure is actually aggregate. But how does this all come together? Well, think of sand as the filler. It slips into the spaces between the gravel, binding everything together more tightly. This interlocking, combined with the adhesive properties of cement, results in a concrete that is both strong and durable. And that's the beauty of aggregate. It's not just a filler, but a vital component that gives concrete its resilience. Without aggregate, concrete wouldn't be as strong and durable as it is. Now let's add some magic to the mix. Ever wonder what gives concrete its adaptability and versatility? That's where admixtures come in. These are special ingredients added during the mixing process to enhance concrete's properties and performance. They're like the secret sauce in a recipe, the element that transforms the ordinary into the extraordinary. There's a whole palette of admixtures available, each serving a unique purpose. Take plasticizers, for instance. These reduce the amount of water needed, making the concrete more workable, and yet maintaining its strength. Then we have accelerators and retarders. As their name suggests, accelerators speed up the setting time of concrete, while retarders slow it down. This proves particularly useful when working in extreme temperatures, or when a longer working time is needed. So you see, admixtures are not just additives. They're game changers, enhancing the properties of concrete and making it fit for a wider range of applications. Admixtures are the secret ingredients that make concrete versatile and adaptable. Concrete isn't just thrown together, it's a carefully crafted recipe. A science and an art, concrete mix design is a process that involves a meticulous balance of components to achieve the desired characteristics. At the heart of this process, we have four primary ingredients: cement, aggregate, admixtures, and water. Each one plays a crucial role, and their proportions need to be just right. Cement is the binder, the element that holds everything together. However, it's not used in abundance as it's the most expensive ingredient. A typical concrete mix might contain about 10 to 15% cement. Next, we have the aggregate, which can make up to 75% of the volume of the concrete. This includes larger pieces known as coarse aggregate and smaller particles, the fine aggregate. These fill up the majority of the space in the mix, reducing the amount of cement needed. Admixtures are the special ingredients. They're used in small amounts but have a significant impact. They can alter the properties of the concrete, making it stronger, more durable, or even changing how quickly it sets. Depending on the specific needs of the project, different admixtures can be used. Last but certainly not least, we have water. The role of water is twofold. It helps to mix all the ingredients together, and it reacts with the cement in a process known as hydration. This is what causes the concrete to harden and gain strength. However, too much water can weaken the final product, so it's essential to get the amount just right. The proportions of these ingredients are determined based on a variety of factors. These include the desired strength and durability of the concrete, the project's specific requirements, the local climate, and even the type of aggregate available. At the end of the day, concrete mix design is a complex process that requires a deep understanding of the materials and their interactions. But when done right, the result is a durable, versatile, and cost-effective building material that has stood the test of time. Like any good recipe, it's all about getting the proportions just right. The journey from raw materials to hardened concrete is quite fascinating. This is where science meets art in the world of construction. Our story begins with a thorough mixing of the components: cement, aggregate, admixtures, and water. This could be done traditionally, but in most cases, concrete mixers are employed to ensure a uniform blend. Now here's a little secret. The water isn't just dumped in all at once, it's added gradually. Why, you ask? This slow introduction of water triggers a process called hydration, where water molecules react with cement to form a paste. This paste then glues the aggregate together, and voila, you have concrete. But it's not just about sticking things together. Hydration also increases the strength and durability of the concrete, making it a reliable material for our buildings and roads. Once our concrete mix is ready, it's time for a little trip. The concrete is transported to its final location, ready to take its place in the world. But it doesn't just plop down anywhere. It's carefully placed and compacted to eliminate any voids. Compaction is a vital step, as it ensures a dense, solid structure, removing any air pockets that could compromise the concrete's strength. And then we wait. This is the curing stage, and it's more important than you might think. Curing is all about maintaining the right moisture and temperature to allow the cement to continue hydrating and gain strength. It's like a fine wine. The concrete needs time to mature to reach its full potential, but we're not done yet. There's still the matter of appearance. Once the concrete has hardened, various finishing techniques can be applied to give it the desired look. It could be smooth or textured, shiny or matte. It's the final touch that transforms raw concrete into a work of art. And that's how we take simple ingredients and turn them into the backbone of modern infrastructure. From skyscrapers to sidewalks, bridges to basements, concrete is everywhere, silently supporting our world. So what have we learned today? We've journeyed through the fascinating process of turning simple materials into something as vital as concrete. We've discovered that cement and concrete are not interchangeable terms. Cement, a fine powder made from limestone and clay, is a primary ingredient in concrete. It's produced through a meticulous process involving crushing, grinding, heating, and cooling. In contrast, concrete is a robust mixture of cement, water, and aggregate. The aggregate, gravel and sand, forms up to 75% of the concrete's volume, providing strength and durability. We've also delved into the role of admixtures, which enhance the properties of concrete, and the intricate art of concrete mix design. Finally, we've seen how the process of mixing, placement, compaction, and curing shapes the final product, leading to the solid, enduring structures we see around us. The next time you see a concrete structure, you'll know the science and art behind its creation.